Hello dear students, welcome back. Today chapter 2 polynomials lecture 2. We are going to see the zero of a polynomial. The first lecture we were discussing about the degree of the polynomial, classification of polynomials on the basis of number of terms. Classification on the basis of number of terms and on the basis of degree of the polynomial. One term monomial, two terms binomial, and three terms are there. A polynomial, that's a trinomial. Then degree one, if a polynomial has degree one, that is linear polynomial, it has degree two, quadratic polynomial, then degree 3 is a cubic polynomial. So that the classification that we have learned in the first lecture. And today please take page number 32, zero of a polynomial. So how to find out what is zero of a polynomial? We shall do some examples. Example 2. Find the value of each of the polynomial. How to find out the value of the polynomial for a particular value? You shall do some examples. Then I will explain what is zero of the polynomial. Okay? We shall do two, three examples. Then we'll come to the point what is zero of the polynomial. Example 2, page number 32. Find the value of each of the following at the indicated value. The first one is question number 1. Example 2, page number 32, example first one is P of x equal to 5x squared minus 3x plus 7. 5x squared minus 3x plus 7. Then find the value at x equal to 1. And say x equal to 1. At then x equal to 1. What to do is here. X equal to 1, we were asked to take the value x equal to 1. So what to do is we need to find out value of p of 1. What is the value of p of 1? Okay, now 5x squared, that is 5 into, whenever x is there, in place of x, you need to put the value 1. The place of x, here is x squared and here is x 3x. So there you put the value x equal to 1. So here you put value 1. So that is 5x squared is 5 into x squared, that is 1 squared, minus 3 into x, that is 1 plus 7. Correct? Very simple. Wherever x is there, you put that particular place 1 value. So now x squared is 1 squared. 3x means 3 into 3 multiplied with x. That is 3x, so 3 into 1. Now equal to 5 into 1 squared, that means 1, minus 3 ones are 3 plus 7. 5 ones are 5, minus 3 plus 7. Now equal to. Now 5 is positive number, 7 is positive. 7 plus 5. 1 minus 3 equal to 1 minus 3 equal to 9. So final answer, that is P of 1 equal to 9. Correct? P of 1 equal to 9. This is the way find the value of the polynomial, then it's equal to 1. Okay? Simple? Okay. Now the second one. So we'll do one more. Please read the second question. What is the second question? You can do it now. We can read. Q of y. Another name is given. Question number 2. Example 2. Question number 2. Q of y. So you can. Variable will be different. The first one was variable x. Now it's a second one. Okay. Now Q of y. Another name. variable name, you can say p of x, q of x, or z of x, any name you can say. So q of y equal to 3y square minus 4y minus 4y plus root 11 and y equal to root 11 and y equal to 2. Now look at here. We need to put the value y equal to 2. Substitute y equal to 2. Now q of y, that is q of 2 equal to, because we need to take the value y equal to 2. So q of 2 is 2 equal to 3 into 3y squared, that is 2 the whole square minus 4y, that is 4 into 2 plus root 11 equals 3 into square. First of all, square it. We need to do the squaring first. 2 raised to 2, that is 4, 2 to the 4 minus 4 to the raised plus root 11 equal to. Now 3 for the 12 minus 8 plus root 11 equal to 12 minus 8. 12 minus 8 is 4. Enough. 4 plus root 11. Because root 11 is an irrational number. So you keep it there. 4 plus 3 cube. It is 3 cube, not 3 vice cube. It is cube here. Okay. 3 cube. So you can write here cube. So 2 to the 4 to the 2 cube. What is 2 cube? 2 cube equal to 2 into 2 into 2. That is 2 to the 4 to the 8. So you will get it as 8 and 3 is the 24. 24 minus 8 is 16 plus. So q of y equal to 16 plus. So next one is one more. You can do another one. Third one. That question. What is the third one? P of t equal to, that one is p of t, the variable is t here, 4 t raised to 4 plus 5 t cube minus t square plus 6 at p equal to a, at t equal to a. What will be your answer? In place of p, you will write a. So p of a equal to 4 into a raised to 4 plus 5 into a cube minus a square plus 6 equal to 4 into a raised to 4, that is 4 a raised to 4 plus 5 a raised to 3 minus a square plus 6 will be your answer. Okay, done. So this is the way we need to find out the value of a polynomial. Okay, now one more we can do. And a simple example. Look at this example. P of x equal to x minus 1. P of x equal to x minus 1. You can see it on the page number 33. Then what will be if you have to find out the value of P of 1 at x equal to 1. So now P of 1 equal to 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Now here P of 1 equal to 0. Now p of 1 equal to 0. Now we come to the point, what is 0 of a polynomial? What is that? Every time the first exercise, p of first one, the answer will be p of 1 equal to 9, and second one is p of 2 was 16 plus root 11. The third one, P of k equal to 4 a squared a raised to 4 plus 5 a cube minus a squared plus 6. Here, in this particular case, P of x equal to x minus 1 equal to x equal to 1. And in this linear polynomial, when you put in place of x, when you put the value 1, then 1 minus 1, then your answer will be
0.
Then but we can say here, we can say 1 is a 0 of the polynomial. Here you can, in the, when you insert, when you add x particular value for x, say, if you are getting 0, then you can, 1 is a 0, if the 0 of the polynomial x minus 1. You can say why? Because when you enter the value 1, this particular value, then your answer will be 0. Correct? So you can say 1 is a 0 of the polynomial. Another question also is there. Example 2, check page number 33. Check x minus whether minus 2 and the 2 are zeros of the polynomial x plus 2. Page number 33, example 3. Check minus 2 and 2. Minus 2 and 2 are zeros of the polynomial. Now how to check? Let p of x equal to, let p of x equal to what is given polynomial x plus 2, correct? P of x equal to x plus 2. Now first of all minus 2. What is p of minus 2? P of minus 2 equal to, you put minus 2 in place of x. Minus 2 plus 2 equal to 0. Minus 2 plus 2 equal to? Minus 2 plus 2 equal to 0. Then what is p of 2? Second value. Minus 2. When you enter minus 2, then your answer will be 0. Then what is p of 2? That is 2 plus 2 equal to 4. Correct? In this particular value, p of x equals plus 2. If you are putting x equal to minus 2, then minus 2 plus 2, 0. If you are putting 2, then 2 plus 2 equal to 4. Then what is the conclusion? Therefore, here you can say minus 2 is a 0 of the polynomial x plus 2 and 2 is not. Here you can say minus 2 is a 0 of the polynomial and 2 is not, because when you enter the value minus 2, then your answer is 0. When you enter the value 2, then your answer is 4. So if you are entering, if you are inserting a particular value, then the value of the polynomial is 0, then that particular value is called a 0 of the polynomial. So moving to the next page, you can see example 5 also there, you can do it. And there are few important observations are there. Page number 34. Page number 34. I can show you. I will show you. These are the important points. You can see here on the your screen. First one is a zero of a polynomial need not be zero. A zero of a polynomial need not be zero. And second one is zero may be a zero of a polynomial, and the third one is every linear polynomial has only one zero, and fourth one is a polynomial can have more than one zero. So these all are the important four points, and remember, so sometimes it will be asked for a one mark question. So dear students, so the next point is remainder theorem, and you will do it the next class. Please do the homework exercise 2.2 for your homework. Please complete it. So we will meet you in the next class with the remainder theorem.